vice principal who called a student the N-word, okay? Do you think they fired the vice principal? No, just transferred the vice principal to another institution. Let's go ahead and do it. Put up a picture of the school. A middle school vice principal at Bennion Jr. High in Taylorsville, Utah, who was found to have used a racial slur against a black eighth grader who happens to be an eighth grade girl, has been transferred to another school. The incident happened during a student protest. Keep the context in mind. This was a student protest outside of the school and passed in May. The employee was put on paid leave while the district investigated and concluded that he did, in fact, say the N-word to an eighth grade girl, during a student protest. You know how these statements come out from school districts that will say something like, we have zero tolerance for racism in our district. Well, that's never true, is it? The family, let's put up a picture of the parents here. The family has called for the employee to be fired, but after their investigation, the Granite School District transferred him to another school within the same district. A district spokesman sent CBS KUTV News the following statement. I'm gonna read it. It says, after an exhaustive investigation, it was determined that the employee, listen, I have to chuckle not to cry. What exhaustive investigation? You talked to the teacher, did you do it? Yeah, I'm sorry, I did it. Girl said, yeah, he called me the N-word. That's exhaustive? After an exhaustive investigation, it was determined that the employee did in fact utilize a racial slur when corresponding with several students. Appropriate corrective action has taken place. Part of that corrective action was a transfer of the employee. They put this in writing, a transfer of the employee. Granite District also spent time with the family and local community groups such as Black Lives Matter, Utah chapter, and the NAACP to work with our administration to maintain and ensure a welcoming and safe environment for all students. We will continue to work towards that end. Sit your $5 ass down before I make change. Now I have to expose every single one of you. I hope Black Lives Matter, I hope you all weren't down with this. I'm an equal opportunity, put my foot up the ass individual. If you all were down with this, shame on you. If the NAACP was down with this, shame on you. Now I'm holding judgment on that part. I'm holding judgment just in case these folks are lying on y'all. But if they're lying on you, you need to say something. Because according to the school system, you all were complicit or at least okay with this arrangement. That's the insinuation from their statement. So if that needs to be cleared for the record, let's go ahead and make sure that it's cleared for the record, because they're putting your name out here like this. All right, put up the picture, Dr. Rich K. Nye is the superintendent of Granite School District, and Jacob Brown is the current principal of Bennion Junior High. The district refuses to reveal the identity of the vice principal, nor the school the vice principal was transferred to. But here's what I'm going to do, okay? That vice principal is dangerous, calling children the N-word, showing racial bias. This school system has taken on a significant liability where they have chosen one individual rather than choosing the progress of their institution or the safety of black children. So if you know who the principal, the vice principal is, and what school he has been transferred to, go to rashadrichey.com, hit contact, and send me the information. All right, time out for this. Dan, thoughts on this case?
This frustrates me to no end, let alone the fact that a vice principal would pick an opportunity for a protest to call, to yell at a black like female student and call her the N-word. I mean, in a dark way, you have to kind of like figure out a way to chuckle at the darkness of this. Maybe that's preparation for how America's gonna work for her in the future. But either way, that's not the environment that should be existing in a school. And a school district should not just go, okay, here's the thing, it was a mistake, but you know, adults make mistakes. So we're going to hide the identity of this person and then shuffle them around the school district. I have some experience with seeing that happen in my own school district at a time, where a problematic principal is essentially just moved to a different school in the same district in an underperforming neighborhood, which doesn't make the matter any better, right? Like, you don't move your worst talent to an underperforming school, because then there are students there who will not actually get the help that they need educationally. It's absolutely repulsive what this district has done. And even if you want this teacher to learn something from this mistake, or like make sure it doesn't happen again, you don't do that by hiding his identity and allowing to protect him from the actual accountability that, quite frankly, if he hasn't gotten this accountability in this far in his life, he more than deserves it.
Yeah, and you can't allow a person who's obviously biased against a racial group to teach or supervise children. I don't know why we're even having the debate here, but this school district has decided to clearly choose the fate of one man, one person, over the fate of their entire school system or the children therein. We're going to continue to follow this story and provide an update as it comes.